What are the two best things in the world?
Traveling
and cars. Road trip time. Okay, usual story, I'm nearly out of fuel. I've managed to get 750 litres out of tank. ...7 kilometres away. And it says I've got 50Ks left. But you can't ever trust those, so I'm gonna have to take it easy. See how it go. I don't know why I always do this to myself. I just want to see how many Ks I can get out of a tank. Oh well, see how we go. So he was telling me I had 35 kilometers left in the tank and I had 15 Ks left according to Google, and then it's just gone to 0 Ks left. I've still got 7 kilometers left according to Google to the next petrol station. And the car's saying I've got 0 kilometers, so back off with the air conditioning, and it's 29 degrees, so I kind of need it, but yeah, the car's saying zero. It dropped off from 35 to zero, and I've got, yeah, now 6.2 Ks. I really hope I make it. I don't want to have to call the breakdown service to get fuel. I'm just literally coasting along as smoothly as possible, getting as high as gear as possible without, you know, straining the engine. Just coasting. It says 2.5 kilometers. Now there's a sign here, 2 Ks. So anxious. Well, I just put in 69 litres, and although the computer was saying I had nothing, apparently it's a 75 litre tank, so there might have been a fair bit more in there perhaps, but I don't know, the digital display was saying nothing, so anyway, 787 kilometres out of that one tank, which is pretty good. I think, what is it? So that's an average of 9 kilometers per liter. I managed, it's gone up to, it was sat on 8.5, pretty steady since I've had the car, but, and in comparison to the Commodore, the most I've ever got is 800 liters out of the tank. I can't remember off the top of my head what size the Commodore tank is now, but I think that might be 75. It's definitely not 80, so yeah, anyway, made it. Now I think we've got 1 hour left. The ride's been pretty comfortable, but I mean, I'm pretty sore, but then I've been driving for like 8 hours, so it's kind of what you expect. Be the same in the Commodore anyway, that's for sure. Nimbin. Directions. 55 minutes, and then my nine and a half hour drive will be over. Actually pretty glad to be behind this car because they seem to be local and they know where all the potholes and things are. You would not want to be going down this road in a sportier car, like, you know, anything lower or nicer, because it's so uneven. I'm gonna stay behind. Yeah, it's terrible roads. Potholes and massive dips on the bridges and everything. You wouldn't want to be driving fast. Lovely countryside though up here. That's an amazing sight. You won't be able to see it, but some really rocky outcrops. Just coming into Nimbin now. I'll try and put some photos up if I get any. but it's pretty dramatic just as you come around the last few corners into Nimbin. Well, made it to the accommodation and it's pretty bloody nice. And the car's not too, I mean, it's dusty. Had to go up an unsealed road, but it's pretty good. Time to get some beers. It's 5:30 and we're just making our way to do the hike.
Woo! Woo!
So good to be out hiking again in the wilderness. Some cool trees. Sam found a snake. This is gonna be hard to zoom in, but I'm not getting any closer. I don't know if you can see that, but Sam found a snake. Didn't you, Sam? And its head was right where we were walking. I don't know what it is yet, but it's like a meter and a half, maybe long. We're not sure what to do. The snake's not moving. We've chucked a few things at it, like sticks, but it's not moving. There's no other way to go. Don't know what to do. So we couldn't get the snake to move. We think it might just be a python, but yeah, we couldn't get it to move. I think because it's cold, it wasn't active yet, which is lucky. So it didn't bite Sam because it was pretty fucking close. But those brambles, because we're not on a proper path, this is a trail, but it's an unmarked trail. So now it kind of disheartened us a little bit. So we're going to go and just find a normal track to do. So that'll be good. If we get out. And we got another one, a red belly.
I've already had it before.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, of course.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it's good. Cheers.
No.
Come on, mate. Just go steady. Ah.